Our Game of the Week is made possible in part by Palermo Pizza, serving the community since 1962. Family owned and operated. Online at palermo-pizza.com. Palermo, home of the 24-inch pizza.
Hey everyone, welcome, or hey everyone, Zach Finkel here, and you are watching Friday Night Highlights on WKTV. Welcome to our fast-paced highlight show featuring all the local high school football that Wyoming and Kentwood have to offer. Week after week, we'll bring you exciting clips from area high school football games in an action-packed show. This will be our final Friday Night Highlights football show of the season, and then we'll return for boys and girls basketball. Welcome to week
Every
nine
high
of the high school football season. We have plenty of highlights to show you tonight, so let's get right into it. And we begin our show with a pair of teams on the verge of the playoffs, with East Kentwood hosting West Ottawa in OK Red action. And the Falcons looking to go ahead in the first as they line up for the short field goal, and it's right down the middle. EK leads 3-0 with 7:40 to go in the opening quarter. There you see the early lead there for East Kentwood. Falcons, Ryan Moore is going to get set up for the kickoff here after the made field goal. There he is lining up for the kickoff as he gets his setup there. Raises the hand, gets the kickoff, and there it is. And the West Ottawa is going to have trouble handling the kickoff return here, but they do get the recovery there. And then quarterback Connor Knapp takes the snap, surveys the field, and decides to take it himself, and he's brought down from behind by EK's Drew Carlin. Panthers in the red zone, and Knapp quickly finds his target over the middle, and Dylan Vrugnik comes down with it for a West Ottawa touchdown. Extra point is going to be good here for the Panthers, and they take a 7-3 lead early in the second quarter. West Ottawa kicking off after the touchdown. Oh, there's another shot of the extra point there. 7-3 in this one. And West Ottawa kicking off after the touchdown. Ball is going to sail out of bounds, but good luck for the Panthers here as a penalty gives them a do-over on the kickoff. And unfortunately, though, on the do-over, it's going to go out of bounds again. So EK is going to start off with great field position here on this next drive. Casey Joppy under center for the Falcons. He's going to hand it off to Elise Konda, who runs right into the middle of the defense, but he keeps his feet and bounces it outside for an EK touchdown, puts the Falcons back on top. Nice play by Konda there to keep his feet and gets into the end zone. And there you see the score there is EK gets the touchdown. They're up 10-7 after that, or 9-7 after that. EK kicks off to West Ottawa. Short return by the Panthers. Gets the ball there, and then he's going to get tackled by Ethan Brown. Nice tackle here on the play, number 21. Panthers back on offense, and a nice play fake to the running back. Fakes out the camera guy. And Knapp finds his receiver on the RPO for a nice gain on the play. Falcons are going to get back on offense here as Joppy is going to hand it off to Elijah Jones this time, and he takes it inside the Panthers' 15-yard line before CJ Traylor wraps him up. Jones again is going to get the football here, this time on a nice swing pass by Casey Joppy. Makes the catch, gets it inside the 10-yard line, fakes out a defender, makes a nice move, and he's taken down after it looks like a first down yardage there. Goal to go situation here for EK, and who else but Elise Konda as he bulldozes his way into the end zone for another touchdown. Extra point is going to be good here for EK as they push their lead to 16-7 with less than 4 minutes in the half. There's the extra point. However, that lead would not hold up as the Panthers make a comeback in the second half. Final score, West Ottawa 34, East Kentwood 22. And with this loss, the Falcons fall to 3-6, which all but leaves them out of the playoffs. West Ottawa now at 4-5. They were sitting at number 31 in the Division I playoff rankings before tonight, so they may have just punched their ticket to the playoffs with that win. Next game, we got Muskegon at Wyoming. Wyoming coming off their first win of the season last week. Muskegon kicking off at Wyoming's Nasser Pernell Reyes, runs a few yards and gets dragged down by DeCarion Taylor. Wolves quarterback Adrian Moore in the shotgun passes to Jack Turveen and gets a couple before getting tackled. Wyoming's, oh, there he is down the sidelines, punts it away, and the Big Reds' Destin Piggy fields the ball and jukes his way up the right side of the field to the Wolves' 30-yard line. Muskegon's Piggy takes the handoff and eats it up about 15 yards before getting tripped at the 10-yard line. Muskegon quarterback Makai Guy throws an incomplete pass under heavy Wyoming pressure. Muskegon quarterback Guy is going to hand it off to Jacoby Price, who rumbles straight up the middle for the score. Extra point kick is going to be no good. The Big Reds lead 6-0 with 8:40 left in the first quarter. And there's the score there on the Wyoming scoreboard. Here's the kickoff by the Big Reds. It gets fielded and bobbled by Donovan Edwards, who quickly picks it up again for a return of 5 yards. There he is, gets the ball and taken down by Muskegon. Wyoming with the ball. Moore's going to hand it off to Edwards on this play, and he's going to get driven back for a loss of yardage. Moore takes the snap again, hands off to Turveen, who almost gets a first down, but then fumbles. Muskegon's Dakarion Taylor recovers the ball and takes it down the field at least 15 yards. Muskegon quarterback Guy here is going to take the shotgun snap, airs it out, but it's going to be incomplete. The Big Reds takes the snap. It's Guy. He fakes a handoff on the keeper and takes it up the middle for close to 10 yards there. Guy with the quarterback keeper again, this time only a few yards before getting tackled. Gets taken down in Wyoming territory there. Guy's gonna take the snap again, hands it off to Jacob Price. He rumbles straight up the middle for a score. Extra point is good. Muskegon leads 13-0 with 5 minutes, five and change left in the first quarter. Final score. Doesn't look like we have a final score there for that game quite yet, but we will get that to you later tonight. And let's jump right into the newest conference standings here in week 9. These are from through 8 games of the season. Keep in mind, the standings were before tonight's games were completed. So we go over here in the OK Gold, where Grand Rapids Catholic Central, they're unbeaten in conference play at 6-0. South Christian sitting right behind them at 5-1. They lost a heartbreaker to Catholic Central last week, and Catholic Central looking to win that conference this year. We go over to the OK Red, where Rockford is sitting at the top of the conference at 6-0. Granville sitting a game back at 5-1. And if we look down here, East Kentwood sitting at 2-4 as well, and 3-5 overall. We go to the OK Green. Muskegon also undefeated in conference play, 6-0 in conference, 6-2 overall on the season. Muskegon Mona Shores sitting just a game back there at 5-1. Wyoming sitting at 1-5 after picking up their first win of the season last week, 1-7 overall in conference play. Holland yet to pick up a win on the season. Over in the OK Silver, Belding 5-0 in conference play, 7-1 overall on the season. So you see Sparta there at 4-1, just a game back. They're 4-4 overall on the season. Kelloggsville yet to pick up a win. We'll see if they get a win as we look at their highlight later tonight. And Godwin Heights sitting at 1-4 in conference play, 2-6 on the season, looking to pick up their third win of the season. We'll check out them later as well. We go over to the Southwest Michigan 8-man league, where New Buffalo and Tri-Unity are currently tied for first at 3-1 in conference play. Tri-Unity will play on Saturday, so they'll be playing Saturday, their final game of the regular season. Wyoming Lee sitting at 1-3 in conference play. They're 4-4 overall. We will check out their game later tonight as well, as they seek their first winning season since 2006. And those are the conference standings going into week 9. We'll be back with some great highlights. Stick around. Okay, gotcha.
Every high school sporting event in the state of Michigan has one thing in common: officials. Every game, every meet, every match. Without officials, there'd be no touchdowns, no three-pointers, no face-offs. Without officials, there'd be no games. Officiating is a great way to give back to your community and stay involved with the sports you love. And officials are needed now more than ever, because without officials, it's just practice.
Let's jump right into Niles Brandywine at Godwin Heights. We start with the Wolverines on offense. Little miscommunication on the handoff, but Godwin able to recover the fumble. Jeff Zelaya on the give, but he is immediately met in the backfield by Gavin Schaaf. Niles Brandywine up by six here. You see Godwin's coaching staff trying to encourage the team. They're got Niles up by six here near the end of the first quarter. Bobcats with possession, and Caden Warfield takes it upfield and picks up a first down and more before being brought down on the play. Godwin Zelaya takes the handoff, stiff arms the defender, tries to bounce it outside, but is tripped up on the play. Ball comes out, but he's ruled down by contact there. You see Godwin's coaching staff saying he's down. Keon Beasley drops back the pass for the Wolverines, plenty of time, and he throws a strike over the middle to Telios Moore, and he sprints into the end zone for six. Touchdown, Wolverines. Godwin is going to attempt the extra point, but it comes up short, so we got a 6-6 ball game here. Bobcats in the red zone as Caden Reef pitches it out to Brock Dye, and he takes a big hit from Godwin's Tajon Allen. He'll be marked down close to the 10-yard line. Godwin seeking the win number three on the season here. Miguel Ocampo gets the carry, and he finds green grass in front of him before being stopped in his tracks at about the Bobcat 40-yard line. Beasley with a quick pass out to the flat to Zelaya, and he picks up a positive gain for the Wolverines. Brandywine back on offense, and Kevin Roberts Jr. breaks it outside for a big gain into Godwin territory. Karis Harris takes the handoff, but he is stuffed by a tough Bobcat defense. Brandywine having trouble with the ball security as Warfield loses the football, but Bobcat's able to jump on it and retain possession. Godwin would not be so lucky as Beasley mishandles the shotgun snap, and Brandywine takes over. Senior night for the Wolverines, and Godwin falls short in this one to finish the season 2-7. Final score, Niles Brandywine 28, Godwin Heights 14. And up next, we have eight-player football with Lee hosting Bloomingdale. We open with Lee attempting the two-point try after a touchdown. This is backup quarterback Jaden Sanchez getting the opportunity with the Legends up big in this one. Sanchez takes the snap and keeps it and pushes the pile for two. Lee is going to lead this one 54-0 in the third quarter. Legends kicking off here. And there's, you see, number three kick it off to the Legends. Great coverage here by Lee as they quickly bring down the kick returner on this one. Hardly got anything on the return there. Great coverage by the Legends. Bloomingdale on offense as number five is going to take the snap. Takes the snap, drifts off to his right, looking for open receiver. He's going to loft it down the field. And good coverage by the Legends as the ball falls harmlessly to the turf. Bloomingdale's nearly going to fumble here as they attempt the pitch. Number 52 maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage before a host of Legends bring him down. Lee back with possession as Sanchez takes the snap and wastes no time finding the green grass in front of him, and he is going to make a house call for a Legends touchdown. Legends go for two, and Henry Kennedy is going to dive his way into the end zone for the conversion. Legends going for the shutout on the final night of the season. 62-0 there in the fourth quarter. Lee kicks off, and Isaac Kibbe, watch this, with a big hit, and you're going to be able to hear the crack of the shoulder pads on this one. There's the return there by Bloomingdale, and watch this hit there. Wow, big one right there. Final score here, Lee 62, Bloomingdale 0. Lee finishes with their first winning season since 2006. Congrats to the Legends. Be sure to check out our WKTV Journal stories this weekend by freelance writers Ty Marzine and Greg Krapek. Ty is going to cover the Bloomingdale at Lee matchup, and Greg is writing about West Ottawa at East Kentwood. Both the Panthers and the Falcons were fighting for a shot at the playoffs in that one. We'll have both those stories for you at WKTVjournal.org. And like always, every week we update our local football scoreboard on our front page of the WKTV Journal. Even though Wayland beat South Christian tonight 49-40, the Sailors are indeed heading to the playoffs. Thanks so much for watching us through the regular football season. Right around the corner is boys and girls basketball, and we'll bring you many clips per week for our Friday Night Highlights basketball show beginning in early December. Thanks again, everyone, for watching throughout the football season.